Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi taala wabarakatuh and good morning everyone. See you again. In this video, I will discuss the lab report writing for experiment 6, which is the title is Diffraction Grating. This is the lab report format that you can refer. If you follow this report format, I'm sure that you will not miss any part of your lab report writing. We will start our report writing with the title. So the title is Diffraction Grating and the learning outcomes or the objective is to determine the wavelength of the laser beam using a diffraction grating and to determine the number of diffraction grating lines per unit length. Okay, after that we will look at the apparatus. So here are all the apparatus that you will use in this experiment. And one of the measuring apparatus is the meter rule. As usual, the range is 0.0 to 100.0 with the unit of centimeter. And the uncertainty is plus minus 0.1 centimeter. In this experiment, you will use two diffraction grating. Diffraction grating A, you will use to determine the wavelength of the laser beam, and diffraction grating B, you will use to determine the number of grating per millimeter. For the raw data A, you record the value for D correctly, and also you record the responding variable, which is L, consistent in decimal places. Also, the calculation for the sine theta, consistent in decimal places, so you will get 2.5 marks. And as usual, my suggestion, you calculate the sum of the X and Y component data because we will use it before you plot the graph. Same for the raw data 2, you record the value for D correctly and consistent in decimal place for the L and also consistent decimal places for the sine theta. So you will get 2.5 marks and you please just calculate the sum of the X and Y component because we will plot the graph. For the first data processing, which is referring to the diffraction grating A, before we plot the graph as usual, you need to calculate the centroid. So your calculated centroid with the correct unit, you will get 1 marks. And for the graph, 7 marks for the graph. So total this part 8 divided by 2 because we have 2 graphs that you're supposed to plot. So you will get 4 marks. This is how you mark your graph. Okay, so the first one, the title is 1 marks. And then the level exists with the correct unit 1 marks. The correct scale or suitable scale at the Y and X axis 1 marks. You plot the point correctly, all 6 points plotted correctly, you will get 2 marks. And then you plot the centroid referring to the calculated centroid, 1 marks. And your baseline supposed to pass in through the centroid and also a few points, so you will get 1 marks. So total marks is 7 marks. And I just go through before you calculate the gradient. The gradient triangle supposed to be greater than 8 cm at the x-axis, you will get 1 marks. And on the graph, you also need to identify the decimal places at the x and y component when you substitute in the gradient calculation. So in this case, referring to the first graph, at the y-axis, it is 4 decimal places and at the x-axis is 2 decimal places. Here is the mark for the gradient calculation. As I told you before, the gradient triangle is for the concept 1 marks. You write down the correct equation 1 marks and you substitute correctly at the y axis. There are 4 decimal places and at the x axis 2 decimal places. So you will get 1 mark for gantian and your final answer with no unit. So the answer is 1 marks. 4 marks for this part, so we divide by 2, so it is equal to 2. And at part C, when you want to calculate the wavelength of the laser beam, we refer to the equation given to us in the theory and we compare with the y, which is equal to mx plus c, and we get the gradient, which is equal to n lambda. Because of our purpose is to calculate the wavelength of the laser beam, where we substitute the number of line per millimeter and also the gradient of the graph that we have calculated earlier, we will get the wavelength, which is equal to 638 nanometer. Because of that, we will get 1.5 marks for this calculation. For the data processing for the second experiment, you will repeat doing the same thing for the diffraction grating B, which is as usual, I just go through. For example, before you plot the graph, you need to calculate the centroid, and your graph will give you 7 marks. Represent the title, label axis, suitable scale, point plotted correctly, centroid plotted, and straight line. And when we refer to the graph, on the graph, you also need to identify the decimal places at the x and y axis. Because of that, at the y axis, we identify the decimal places, which is equal to 3 decimal places, and at the x axis is 2 decimal places. So for the calculation of the gradient, referring to the graph, the gradient triangle is supposed to be greater than 8 cm at the x-axis. You substitute the gradient correctly, referring to the decimal places that we have identified. And your answers for the gradient, which is 14.49 times 10 power of negative 2. So you will get 4 marks and divide by 2, it is equal to 2 marks. And to calculate the number of line per millimeter, we refer to the equation given, and when we compare the two with the straight line graph, we get that the gradient is equal to n lambda. And because we want to calculate the number of line per millimeter, we need to substitute the gradient of the graph and also the wavelength that you have calculated in part A. Because of that, you will get the number of line per millimeter is equal to 2 to 7. Because of that, the marks is 1.5. Now, let's look at the discussion. So, the first part of the discussion is, you need to compare the value of wavelength of the laser beam and the number of line per millimeter for grating B with their actual value. Because of that, you need to state, your statement is, from the experiment, the wavelength of the laser beam obtained is 638 nanometer, which is in the range of or equal to the standard value of 622 nanometer until 780 nanometer. And for the second discussion, from the experiment, the number of line per millimeter obtained is 2 to 7 line per millimeter, which is less than the actual value of 300 lines per millimeter. Do take note that when we compare the value, you need to state the value that you get from the experiment and mention either it is equal, greater or lower compared to the actual or standard value. So every time make sure that you have this all this point for the first part of the discussion. The second part of the discussion is, you need to state two sources of error, referring to the systematic error and random error, and also step taken to overcome. So referring to this experiment, I give you two, which is, first is the random error, because of we use the meter rule. So we have the source of error, which is parallax error, while taking the reading of the distance d using the meter rule. And step taken to overcome, the observer I should be perpendicular to the scale. So this pairs of source of error and step taken to overcome correct, you will get 1 marks. And the second one for the source of error and also the step taken to overcome correct, you will get the second marks. For the third part of the discussion, you need to state two precautions taken before and while doing the experiment. So I give you here three precautions. So you as long as you can write down the two precautions correct, you will get 2 marks. And for the precaution, as usual, for example, ensure that the screen is parallel to the diffraction grating so that the incidence rate is normal to the diffraction grating. And second example is, the laser beam The laser pen has to be held patiently until the spots are marked. This is because we need to take the correct spots order. So for the precaution, the tips for the precaution is you need to write down why, the reason why you take that precaution. Okay, so for the two precaution correct, you will get 2 marks. And lastly, for your lab report writing, you need to do or you need to write down the conclusion. Your conclusion is refer to the learning outcome, and because of for this experiment, we have 2 values that you want to determine. So your conclusion is from the experiment, the value for the wavelength of the laser beam is 638 nanometer, and the number of line per millimeter for the diffraction grating B is 227 lines per millimeter. So that's the conclusion. You will get 3 marks. So that's it for the guideline to write down the lab report for experiment 6, which is diffraction grating. Thank you so much for watching, and I hope that you do take care of yourself, stay safe, and I wish you all the best. If you think that this video helped you to write down the correct lab report, so can you please click the subscribe button, like, and please share this video with all of your friends. If you leave the comment, so I can improve my next video. So please wait for my next video, which is the revision for the multiple choice question for chapter 4, 5 and 6. Thank you very much everyone, and see you in the next video.